human beings of the internet.
Hello, editing Joe Seti here. Ignoring that lisp-filled greeting, please excuse that thing on my lip. I actually didn't see that the whole time, even though I was literally in a bathroom filled with mirrors, but I can promise you that it's not like a booger or anything. Moving on to the video.
Hello, fellow human beings of the internet. Hi, how are you? Just trying to get started talking because I don't talk often at all, and that's double when it comes to the camera. Today, we are getting ready to transform this piece of trash bathroom. Pre-warning is very disgusting, just like a lot of areas in my life, but you know what? This year I'm fixing things one step at a time, starting with this. I sincerely apologize that I'm this much of a pig. There's like stuff everywhere, a basket full of random crap, a whole bunch of toothbrushes for one mouth, all of this crap and this nasty. Okay, let's just blur that out. This laundry bag that's literally right next to the tub for some reason. And of course, a whole bunch of random products on the top bar. Oh my gosh. And not to mention, this dirty bathtub. Yeah, pretty gross, and I'm sorry, but I can promise you that it gets a little bit better than this. Like, there's no way it gets worse than this. I pretty much have already a list planned out, like, the wannabe Girl Scout in me, of the things I want to buy, the exact steps I need to take, and what I'm going to make, and assemble, and decorate. So, let's get started. If I could take you up in boom, boom, boosh, boom, boom, tell me I'm the only one that you know. Life could be a dream, sweetheart. Everything, and now it is time to start cleaning. First things first, we have to take out everything. And I really want to clean everything. I want a fresh layer to start working on, so I'm going to spray the walls and clean them as well.
Excuse me, señor. It is not ole ole. No, si. It is only one ole. Like this.
Hi. Alright, so now it's time to clean the bathroom. Hello, from this angle. Initially, I was going to clean this rustic hot mess, but I really can't be bothered, to be honest. So instead, I'm going to be using this. The color is an Heirloom white. Basically, it's kind of a 2-in-1, a paint and a primer, and it is fast drying, so I should probably hide the mirror. One second. I'm just gonna use an old canvas that I have to block the mirror from getting sprayed, because if it gets on there, there's no way I'm scraping it off. So, things you do.
And now, I present you the most amateur fixing holes in walls tutorial you have ever seen. All night long, I've had the most terrible impulse to do something.
Who is this, an impulse?
Ready, get, set, go. We are going to use this Dry Dex thing, which is basically a faux wall concealer that you can add to the holes in the wall. A few weeks ago, I had tried to install some floating shelves, and as you can see, that did not work out. First, you grab some of it using any random object you have lying around. I'm gonna use this end of the paintbrush. Second, scrape it along the wall and gently pat it. And lastly, just kind of spread it out until it looks as flat as possible. So at first, the color is gonna be this pinkish purple, but after some time, it actually ends up drying white. Speaking of the color white, we are going to paint this wall. Which color? You guessed it. White. Okay.
You know what, an upside to this small bathroom is that painting can be done like a lot quicker. Like I've only spent like 2 minutes and look, I'm basically already done with this wall. I mean, I still have like 1, 2, 3 left, but I'm like basically almost done. Good morning, everyone. It is now the next day, another day to keep going in this room. So the paint has dried and the bathroom is coming along really nicely. And it is time to start the furniture assembly, and next we'll be doing some DIY. Alright, so I went ahead and brought in the Hejne and the Ivar. That's definitely not how you say it. The Swedes are screaming. And it's now time to assemble it. Alright, I'm just gonna lay this on the toilet because if I do this standing like this, we're gonna have an issue. Alright, so since the IKEA in Atlanta is like literally always out of stock for some reason, instead of getting the actual Hejne shelf that's supposed to go with the long wood pieces, I ended up getting the Ivar because that's literally all they had in stock and it had the same wood finish, so you just make do with what you have. Another important tip is that when you're actually drilling, you want to make sure that you don't drill too far up or too far down, because then, you know, the drill is just going to get stuck and you're not going to be able to use it. There's no like control Z button. If you mess up, say goodbye. So it's kind of looking like tarantula legs, kind of, but I think the more shells you add, like the stabler it'll get. You're supposed to add a crossbar, but... Okay, so over here in this corner, I'm gonna install some shelves. I have some IKEA brackets, and I also have these marble flat thingies from a previous project from my bedroom makeover. I didn't want to throw them away, so instead I thought these could act as shelves. So I'm gonna use my big ruler to accurately place the shelves on the wall, because there's nothing more infuriating than slightly slanted shelves. Ooh, my alliteration game is strong. I'm gonna install 3. It's pretty simple, it's just wham bam, thank you ma'am. Okay, so that's basically it. I'm pretty much done with all the furniture. Now it's a matter of putting everything back and making a little decorations here and there.
Then I made a macrame plant hanger and hanged it in the vent because why not? I also took out this curtain and made some new ones. And because I have a macrame obsession, I got some random jars that I didn't throw away and just glued around and around for like half an hour. And finally, I started putting up all of my stuff and we are done. Starting on this side of the bathroom, we have our big boy shelf that holds the majority of my products. At the bottom is an exciting small laundry basket for, can you guess it, dirty clothes. The next shelf holds an IKEA Raabla box for hair things, i.e. a blow dryer, various irons, and an obnoxious amount of scrunchies. This lovely section is for catfishing and the root cause for all of my acne. And on the top part, we just have some miscellaneous stuff. And over here is a double-purpose stool for sitting and holding all of the shower-related products that is aesthetically placed and not at all jumbled up together. No, no, no. And here we have a mirror in the shower, which truly is a godsend because unfortunately, I don't have an eyeball on the palm of my hand, so I have this mirror. As you can see, I kept the bathroom intentionally clear except for the mirror because it's just a lot easier to clean this way if there's not a whole bunch of stuff in the bathtub. On this side of the room is the toilet that's actually out of order, but we're not gonna talk about that. This bucket here actually used to be a candle holder. I unscrewed the hanger, removed this thing, and just flipped it upside down so it can hold the toilet scrubbing thingy. I switched out my old curtains for this beautiful rose embroidery one. I added some propagation plants that I clipped from the backyard and just put them inside my macrame jars. The best thing about this whole room is probably the daylight light bulbs. It gives the room an open, airy, lively feel. Like, it literally feels like you're standing inside a sunny garden, and nothing brightens up my mood like some good old vitamin D. For the mirror, I used a hot glue gun to add some macrame rope around the border. I haven't seen this at all before in a bathroom, but if this ever becomes a thing, just know you saw it here first, lol. And over here, we just have some miscellaneous products like toothbrushes and hairbrushes. Under the sink is a cabinet that serves as a storage dungeon for a bunch of random stuff that rarely see the light of day. I have a nail kit that I never use, extra skin and hair related things that couldn't fit the shelves, what is literally an old powder detergent bucket that holds all of the cleaning supplies, and enough pads to last me through the next several apocalypses. And that's a wrap, folks. I hope you enjoyed the video. All of the prices slash products I bought are in the description. And just a reminder, it's not about how much you have, but it's all about how you spend it. And on that cheesy, cringy note, we will end here. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you again next time.